Kameli Setback reporting.
There have been lots of rumors speculating, floating all over the place that Conor McGregor was knocked out by Brandon Rios. I reached out to Brandon and I got an answer. And I could have just posted, Brandon Rios told me A, B, C, D. But instead I got Brandon on the phone. Thank you, Brandon. He was very busy tonight. He didn't have time for an interview. Still, he did one. Check it out. Here's what Brandon Rios has to say about those rumors. Him and Conor McGregor.
Brandon Rios, did you knock out Conor McGregor in sparring?
No, man. Fucking Parker's fucking he was saying that. I don't know, dude. I don't know how that shit got rumored, man. But no, it never happened. I don't even know. I never met that motherfucker and never, I don't know nothing about him. But I would love to spar him.
All right, there you have it. You heard Brandon Rios. That's all a rumor. Thanks, Brandon. We'll see you soon.
Everybody, it's a fucking rumor, man. It's, the world's going crazy. I've been getting fucking text messages, calls, and shit like that blowing up.
So we're putting the record straight. You have not sparred McGregor. You never met him. You never saw him. You never knocked him out. You never even met the guy.
Don't even know who the guy is, honestly. I don't even know who he is. Even though I watch MMA, the only way I know who he is because when he got choked out by fucking, what's his name? Nate Diaz.
But that's about it. All right, there you have it. Brandon, enjoy your evening. We'll see you soon. Thank you.
All right, buddy.
All right, late.
So there you have it. You heard Brandon Rios. He never met Conor McGregor. He never stepped in a ring with him, never stepped in a building with him. The only time he's seen him was on TV when McGregor fought Nate Diaz. Other than that, Brandon Rios has never had any interaction with Conor McGregor. So obviously he did not knock him out in sparring. As far as we know, Conor McGregor has never been knocked out in sparring or in a fight. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Setback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Setback. And the best way, by the way, to squash rumors is to get it straight from the source. Like we just did.
It's the fight game. It's a ruthless business. People will do ruthless things to try and get an edge. It's all good, but I know the person I am. I'm dozing home. Now I'm hanging over there.
And Conor, physically, I've seen John Cavanaugh join Mr. Helwani. He said you're about 3 weeks out, 2 weeks ago, and you still have 7 weeks to play.
Oh, yeah, look at the shape. Look at the shape of me up there. I'm a fucking animal. He's in high heels. He was in high heels tonight. And I'm in the low tops. And then he still has that hat on his head. What's up with that hat? I tried to hit it off, and the thing was glued to his head. I was like, the fuck is on? What's under that hat? But,
Thank you.
Sure.
Can we
do a couple of
shout-outs
for the troops?
Sure.
Let me just zoom in on you, get you in focus. We're going to do two shout-outs. We're going to do two shout-outs. Okay. One for the troops, and then one for U.S. Army Reserves, okay? So 5, 4, 3, 2.
Shout-out to the troops. Thank you for all the support, and thank you for what you are doing.
Okay. U.S. Army Reservist, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Shout out to the U.S. Army Reserves. Thank you for the support and keep doing what you're doing.
All right, now two questions, all right? So about the psychological warfare between two fighters, describe it.
Yeah, it's one third of a fight. There's the psychological battle, there's the verbal battle, and then there is the physical battle. They're all equally important. They're the three methods of a true fight. So that's it. That's the way I see a fight: verbal, psychological, mental, and then physical.
And now, last question: what's on your gym playlist, man?
Rap. All day fucking long. They can try and make those accusations about me all day long, but leave them to it. I'm blasting the shit.
I think so.
I enjoyed it. I mean, it's getting to that step. By the end of it, I was like kind of just zonked over. Like I was like just chilling on the chair and flexing. I'm just trying to look good. Hopefully someone will get me in a nice shot with the coat. But it is getting to that stage. It's like, right, let's get the fucking thing wrapped up now. Do you know what I mean? So there's only someone. He's saying the same shit over and over again. Right. Some of the things, the timing on some things are pretty good, but whatever. It's that time now, right?
Was it hard to hear what he was saying?
Yeah, I couldn't hear. I could hear. You know, there was like some sort of echo. Toronto was the best thing to hear. Perfectly. Couldn't hear a thing in LA. I could hear some things, but then it went on so long. I was kind of like, right, what the fuck is going on here?
Started to feel a little hostile, especially when the two teams got up. Feel like it's about to cross
maybe,
some kind of line?
I'm just telling them, you just be very, very careful. That's what I'm telling them, from face to face, be very, very careful, because maybe I'm fine, I won't abide by the Marcus of Queensbury rules. So just be very, very careful how you speak my name, and that's it. But when those juiceheads start rolling up to me. I was on bail, I was actually, I used to be flexing or something, just on the chair. And then I saw him, and I was like, what? And I jumped up, and then he wasn't there. And I was like, where the fuck is he? And then it was just handbags after that. And then he was out there, and then he squared off.
So he came here just moments ago, and he was very upset because he said that you talked about his daughter, you talked about the mother of his children.
He
talked about the race thing. He thinks that it's getting to that point where it's becoming racially. Are you going there?
No. If anything, I wanted to kind of squash that and have a little bit of fun. That was a playful thing. You know what I mean? I included the doctor. I had a, you know what I mean? It's all fun on my part. If he is in that mindset, well, then that's his business. Am I going to? I don't care. I don't care. I know who I am. People who are watching know. You know what I mean? So if he's upset and angry, well, then great.
Can you clear up those people bringing up the dancing and things like that? Is that what you're trying to insinuate? What are you trying to say?
What do you mean, insinuate?
People are saying, oh, Conor McGregor is racist because he's saying dance.
That's ridiculous. The hell does that make sense?
I don't know. I honestly don't know.
That's what's annoying me. I mean, that's why I wanted to bring it up today in a playful way. I mean, how could you say that when look at me, for fuck's sake? I mean, I'm coming out rapping, Lady Biggie. I'm shouting, giving respect. You know what I mean? I'm engaging in the entire. I pulled out Jay-Z's album and all tonight, for fuck's sake. So look, I'm a big fan of the shit. I'm a big fan of the culture. You know what I mean? Like I said, he asked me what my playlist is. All I listened to was rap. You know what I mean? So I'm just out there having fun. If he's out coming in here thinking he's disrespectful and he's angry, so what? Deal with it.
Why did you wear this? What was the inspiration behind it?
I was back in New York. I had a mink last night. It was hot out and I was going topless shopping. And I was just going around the shop and I saw this and I said, okay, I'm gonna stay topless and just throw this coat over it. And then I showered up and then there's a big red carpet and I was like, what? It was like a blade in Victoria's Secret yoke or something, you know what I mean?
Right. And how do you attack London now? After today, you know, do you feel like there's a certain
I will see what happens. Yeah, it'll still be in his box, but if we're getting hostile, we're getting hostile.
Are you worried it will?
No. I mean,
so
look, we'll see what happens, isn't it? It's easy to say here in Brooklyn. Ask me after a 10-hour flight all the way to London, sure. And then no sleep, and then thrown onto the stage, how I'm gonna feel. Maybe if something kicks off, it will be after that long flight. You know what I mean? So we'll see. But I'll be ready for anything. Many times he's right there with his back to me. If I really did want to, I could just latch onto his neck and sleep him. None of those big juice monkeys could do anything about it. You know what I mean? They're look at the size of those two fools he had. You know what I mean? Big, blown up. They couldn't even run back and forth. So they could do nothing to stop to take me around his neck. So
what do you think when he comes out with the flag? Is that too much?
No, he's rocking the flag. You know, I'm like, I had this kind of cape on. I was like, this probably looks better than this. That's actually what I thought in my head at that very moment. I was like, his cape looks probably better than my cape because I love that flag. And we threw it on the ground as I was debating, but I was like, you know what? I fucking threw it at his face yesterday. We'll call it even on that one.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSekpak.